Whoa. Oh my gosh. This might be the holy grail of the whole UCLA Botanical Garden. Here at the UCLA Botanical Garden, I'm going to show you some of the houseplants that they have. Of course, we have the ferns. It's really cool to actually see the spores of ferns. These alocasias are actually planted like in the swamp, so they're getting a ton of water. And look at the bird's nest fern that we plant indoors all the time, except for this is massive. Here's a really cool looking palm. Something like this we might actually have indoors. It's getting just a little bit too much light maybe here. Banana leaf trees there. Absolutely massive elephant's ears. Oh look, and there's a turtle. Looks like a bamboo palm planted out perfectly under this bamboo. It gives it the adequate shade it needs to grow. Notice how the plants aren't planted in the full sun out there. Here are those massive alocasias. It's probably 10 feet tall. And here we have probably the coolest thing, which is just a massive monstera. And this monstera just stretches and has a really good source of water. And there you have normal decay and yellowing of leaves. If your plant leaves are yellowing, it's completely natural. And there you actually have the monstera fruit. Rare to see, but with enough light like this, the monstera is rooted into the tree with the air roots and has climbed up about 10 feet. It's a bird of paradise, just thriving. Now here's a cool way of how we learn how a plant gets its name. This is the bamboo palm, and it looks a whole lot like bamboo, but it's actually a palm about 15, 20 feet tall, amongst other actual bamboo. This is the perfect example of what a forest understory looks like. And this creates the perfect light for houseplants to thrive. This is actually, looks like a different variety of monstera I've never seen before. And it's tapped into this palm. Really cool, we have one here in West LA. Again, another example of unhealthy leaves in the wild. And some browning, and even dying off branches, which happens in the wild. A lot more than it happens in the house. Ah, look, it's a Ruffudophora actually. It's not a monstera. It's the same one. I was wrong. And look, it's flowering. It flowers just like a monstera. This is so neat. Look at this staghorn fern. Almost looks parasitic at this point. Really cool to see in the wild. You can see they've attached it on to help it out. And then we have the maidenhair fern, actually in the wild. Super hard to care for plants. But here it is thriving in the understory. Whoa. Oh my gosh. This might be the holy grail of the whole UCLA Botanical Garden. Look at this monstera that's climbed this palm. This monster has climbed all the way to the top of about a 30-foot palm tree. And look at its air roots all the way down. The craziest air roots. And this is the stalk of the monstera. I think we'll end it there. The UCLA Botanical Garden is super cool. Try and make it out here if you're ever in LA. It's a hidden gem on UCLA's campus. Thank you guys for watching. We hope you enjoyed, and we will see you next time.